What a long wait it has been for the boxer wearing red representing Ireland to make her Olympic debut. It is day 10 of the Olympic boxing tournament, and making her way towards the ring for the very first time is the reigning, defending, four-time world championship gold medalist representing Ireland, Katie Taylor, an iconic figure in the sport of women's boxing. And just listen to the support that is on hand, and indeed look at the support that's on hand. But the ovation will be louder for this woman, because it's the home fighter, Natasha Jonas, representing Great Britain, who is her opponent in this quarter-final bout. Second bout for Jonas, having prevailed in a preliminary round yesterday. And what a moment for both of these boxers. They met in the Stranger tournament in Bulgaria last year. It was Jonas who came out. It was Jonas who came out on the wrong end of a points verdict on that particular occasion. From her point of view, she said she has improved since that time. And here the two boxers will compete on the Olympic stage before a capacity-filled crowd.
Well, nothing but pure concentration on the faces of both of these boxers. They're giving nothing away walking into this ring. They know what they've got to do. They will have taught their tactics with their coaches. And
the opening bell sounds in the women's 60-kilogram lightweight bout between the reigning, defending, four-time world championship gold medalist representing Ireland wearing red, Katie Taylor, and her opponent wearing blue, boxing out of the southpaw stance, is Natasha Jonas representing Great Britain. And the noise level here at the XL Arena in London's Docklands is lifting the roof off the venue. Home fighters in many respects are both of these. Difficult to discern who is the home fighter, because Katie Taylor has got voluminous support and numerous fans on hand. And it's a competitive beginning to this opening round.
Oh, some great combinations by both boxers there. Katie with her classic 3-4 punch combinations, blistering speed. She moves out the way of any potential counters.
These two boxers met at the Stranger Memorial Tournament in Bulgaria last year. It was Katie Taylor who prevailed on points on that particular occasion, but Jonas said that she is an improved boxer since that time, and she just repels the straight shot attack of Katie Taylor. Jonas said that when they met last time, as Taylor does get through with a couple of good right hands out of that orthodox stance, but Jonas said when they met on that occasion, she had only just joined the podium squad, and so wasn't receiving the benefit of full-time coaching and training and expertise on hand at the English Institute of Sport in Sheffield.
Yeah, the improvement she has made over such a very short period of time is immense. And the same has been for the other British boxers on that podium squad. They have such support, and they've made an exponential improvement in their boxing ability. As she lands with a great right hand there.
The noise level here being generated and the atmosphere created is absolutely wonderful. It's the inaugural Women's Olympic Boxing Tournament here at the XL Arena, and it's another sellout crowd. And at the end of the first round, it is the reigning four-time World Championship gold medalist who leads by 5 points to 2 in Katie Taylor's favour. Let's listen into the corners.
Yeah, there we see an exchange of punches there. Katie throwing a larger number of punches, but Jonas comes back there with a classic right hook. Yeah, 4, 5, 6 punch combination there by Taylor. None of them particularly clean, apart from that one, that great left hook there, and she throws the most amazing check hook, as you've just seen there, and she moves off and cannot be countered.
The second of a scheduled 4 2-minute rounds in the women's 60 kilogram lightweight division between the boxer wearing red, the number one seed in the tournament, Katie Taylor, representing Ireland in this, her Olympic debut, having received a bye in the opening round by virtue of that number one seeding. And her opponent, boxing out of the southpaw stance, wearing blue, is Great Britain's representative, Natasha Jonas from Liverpool. And the atmosphere that is being generated here in this boxing venue, XL Arena South 2, is reminiscent of a football match as Taylor just loses her footing, accidental leg sweep, and the atmosphere is absolutely extraordinary for these two boxers competing beneath the ring lights on the Olympic stage.
Unbelievable, Ron. I don't know if the viewers can get the full appreciation of this atmosphere, but it's blistering. You can't hear yourself think as these two boxers, no respect between them, no reputation at hand, as Jonas lands a fantastic shot. Snap Katie Taylor's head back.
It was a good left cross, and then the two fighters engaging in an exchange. It was Taylor who had the last word on that occasion with a short right hand. She initiates the action once more, scoring with a good right hand to the body, but it's a right hand response from Jonas. Inside the final minute of this second round, so many similarities between these two boxers, both of them outstanding footballers. It was an injury during her football career while on a scholarship to university in the United States of America. That was the catalyst for Natasha Jonas to take up boxing. She returned to the UK, just wanted an activity to help her stay in shape and prevent her from putting on weight. She found a boxing ring, and here she is competing in the Olympic tournament. Beautiful three-punch combination from Taylor.
Yep. Taylor's footwork is coming to the fore now. You see her. Oh, she gets caught there by a right hand by Jonas as she moves off to the side.
Taylor is also an outstanding footballer. She's represented her country at that sport. Beautiful shots once more, and that right hand to finish the combination from Taylor was exquisite. Right on the button. And Taylor, as fantastic as a footballer she was, it was growing up watching her dad shadow box in the kitchen, which was her lure into the sport of boxing. And the world's best maintained that 3-point advantage. It was an even round of boxing at 5 points apiece. But it's Taylor, by virtue of the 3-point cushion she created in the first round, who retains her advantage.
Yeah, furious round that. We see Jonas there catching Katie with a fantastic backhand. But Katie catches Jonas again with that classic check hook. Furious exchanges over that round. Jonas now has it all to do going into the last two rounds. She needs to up her work rate just a little bit.
We're into the second half of this women's 60 kilogram contest, the third of a scheduled 4 2-minute rounds between the reigning defending world champion, Katie Taylor from Ireland wearing red, who just took a good right hand from Jonas out of that southpaw stance. But look at the response it elicits. Both boxers going toe-to-toe just beyond center ring as Natasha Jonas has to overturn a 3-point deficit as she trails by a score of 10-7. Good body shot with the left hand from Taylor during that combination. And it's Taylor who's getting on the front foot now and just beginning to assert her dominance as we approach just 30 seconds elapsed here in round number three.
Yeah, good defenses there by Jonas, but she's just overwhelmed by the sheer volume of punches that Taylor throws.
Beautiful punching and accuracy from Katie Taylor, and it brings about the first standing count of the contest. Jonas, her head's clear. She holds up her hand to intimate to the referee that she's okay. And that, remember, just 1 point, so it's not like professional boxing, but Jonas under real pressure now, and Katie Taylor is really going through the gears and then loading with some accurate, hurtful shots at close range. The four-time world champion She's so popular in Ireland that she was selected with the honour of being flag bearer during the opening ceremony. Boxing very much in her blood. Her father, Peter, was a light heavyweight champion of Ireland in the mid-1980s. She learned her trade by watching him shadow box in the kitchen. And she's turned out to be a rather decent amateur boxer herself, the four-time world champion. 5 European titles as well, 2 national titles. One of the most decorated boxers in the sport. And she's doing her thing superbly well as she's putting Jonas under real pressure during the course of this third round.
Jonas really struggling to deal with those combinations and to throw her own counters. She worked well earlier on the inside, but it's dependent whether the judges will count those body shots.
Jonas competing valiantly as we approach the final 10 seconds of this round, but Taylor targets the body once more. Jonas continuing to respond with her own. But the boxer who had the better of that third round, beyond any question, is Katie Taylor. She's extended her lead by just 1. It is now she extended her lead by 2, so it now stands at 8, 19 points to 11 in favour of Katie Taylor after a dominant third round display.
Serious words there by her father, Peter, and coach in the corner. She needs to just hold it together. She's 8 points up. She doesn't need to be getting into a fight, is what he's saying.
As we enter the fourth and final 2-minute round in this women's 60-kilogram lightweight contest, the instructions in the corner couldn't have contrasted more starkly, because the boxer wearing blue, representing Great Britain boxing out of the southpaw stance, Natasha Jonas, is trailing by 8. And the instructions were she has to roll the dice, she has to go in and score points without reply. And the atmosphere once more is absolutely fantastic here at the XL Arena in London's Docklands. It's more like a football match or an All-Ireland final, but it is Olympic boxing, women's Olympic boxing, for the very first time in the 108-year history of this most storied tournament in the Olympic Games. And Jonas is trying to land those punches without reply. For her part, Katie Taylor's father and coach Peter Taylor saying she doesn't need to get into a fight, but that's exactly what Jonas is trying to turn this round into. But look at the response from Taylor, the number one seed in the tournament, the reigning defending 4-time world champion, AIBA's Boxer of the Year in 2008, really putting her vast array of talents on display. She scored effectively to the body.
A great left hook there to the body. That would be hurtful for Jonas. Taylor really listening to the instructions of Peter. He said, don't get involved. And if you do, you keep your guard nice and tight, move the head. And that's exactly what she's doing. They have a symbiotic relationship, and that's one of the ingredients for their successful achievement to date.
Jonas targeting the body. You see her visibly biting down on that gum shield in an effort to overturn the deficit, but she shipped a big right hand and is forced to take her second standing count of the contest. And it really is a cacophonous noise being generated by this 10,000 strong crowd. And after that standing count, Katie Taylor wages war to the body of Jonas once more, but Jonas, impossible to deter. She continues to come forward looking for her own shots, but now she's being forced backwards towards the neutral corner. And as the closing bell sounds, Jonas just sags into the ropes, but there is a sporting embrace between these two familiar rivals, and it's a standing ovation here at the XL Arena. But there can be no doubt about the victor. Katie Taylor, the reigning, defending, 4-time world champion, is living up to her billing as she produces a fantastic display on her Olympic debut. It is commiserations, one suspects, from the coaching team of Paul Wormsley and Lee Pullum in that blue corner. But Natasha Jonas gave it her all. She competed until the final bell, but one suspects that Katie Taylor, Ireland's flag bearer during the opening ceremony, has guaranteed a place on the medal podium with a dazzling display against Great Britain's Natasha Jonas.
Absolutely. You see Jonas here landing with a good right hand and the receiving a count there from Taylor. If indeed Jonas is not the victor on this occasion, then it's a win for women's boxing overall. What a fantastic performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 26 points to 15 in the last quarter, representing Ireland, Katie Taylor.
A standing ovation for Katie Taylor. And let's not forget Natasha Jonas, who played her part in what was an absolutely thrilling women's bout. A fantastic advertisement for boxing, but make no mistake about the boxer who has guaranteed her place on the Olympic medal podium to add even more hardware to her bursting trophy cabinet. It is the world's number one, the number one seed, the four-time reigning defending world champion, Katie Taylor, who is through to the semi-finals and guaranteed at least a bronze medal. But given how she performed, who would bet against her for gold? What a round of applause and ovation that both of these boxers are receiving as they leave the Olympic boxing arena. Katie Taylor will be back. Natasha Jonas acquitted herself very well indeed, but that brings an end to her Olympic Games in the quarterfinals.
Well, we wanted to showcase women's boxing on this Olympic stage, and this bout, amongst others, just shows how much style, how much technique, and how fantastic women's boxing is on this Olympic stage. What a fantastic advert for this sport.
The fans on